What's going on, Reef Builders? Jake Adams here, and I'm really excited to share with you the nearly completed fish system. Now, reef tanks are really focused on corals and invertebrates, but fish play a very important role in keeping our tanks alive. A lot of people really, really love the fish. For me, they're partially functional, you know, unless they're in a dedicated aquarium. But needless to say, it's really, really important for us to quarantine our fish, to condition our fish, to make sure they're in really, really good shape before you put them in an environment like an aquarium where it's gonna be really hard to take them out. So that's why I have this dedicated fish system. And as I've shown you before, this is the Mode Aquarium's retail rack system. And it's a really, really great platform. It's three tanks plus a sump, each 50 gallons. They have high clarity glass. They're kind of broad and shallow, so you can keep more fish in there than, say, like a 55 gallon tank. I'm really, really excited to show you the completed fish system, because there's not as many moving parts as a reef tank, which is why it's one of the first systems to be pretty much completed here at the studio. The stock Mode Aquarium's retail rack system comes with a single return pipe that feeds each tank once, and it has three overflow drains, both a surface drain and a subsurface drain, with Durso standpipes in each one of them for pulling water both from the bottom of the tank and also from the surface. And the Durso standpipe really, really helped to quiet it down. But when I saw this system, I knew that it would be a great platform for me to kind of soup up what this thing can do. So it's taken me a little while. Thank you, Mode Aquariums, for your patience, to finally put it all together and install all the features that I wanted for this particular aquarium. So the main thing that took some time is I drilled each tank like I showed you on a previous video. But what's really different from the stock aquarium is I've drilled each tank to have its own lock line return nozzle with a ball valve, so I can adjust the water flow into each system. So not only can I adjust the water flow going to each system, but I can do it from the front using that lock line ball valve. And I wanted to do this just to have a nice outlet of water in each tank. I feel like that's healthy and important for the health of the fish, to keep the food moving, to stimulate them to eat more food, especially for the picky eaters, but more importantly, to flush away all the waste that might build up if it was really stagnant in the aquarium. So I've installed those in each of the aquariums. I've got them rippling the surface just right so I can see what's happening. And I'm really, really thrilled with how that came along. One thing that I really didn't have to adjust at all on the Mode Aquarium's retail rack system is that beautiful finish that comes with these, hinged lids. And they're really, really neat, because when you lift it up, it basically blocks the light from blinding your eyes. As you can see, as I'm lifting this up, the lights are in your eyes, and as it leans back, it actually blocks it, but it doesn't block the light from going into the tank. And one, you know, easy to overlook feature of the Mode Aquariums is these super tight fitting lids. And this actually has three different purposes. One, it keeps everything kind of quiet and keeps down the humidity or the evaporation rate, so you don't have to top it off as often. Two, it also keeps the fish in place. So these are really, really tight fitting, and it's one of those things that's kind of easy to overlook when you have a fish tank that you really need a way to keep them in, because if you leave it open, the fish will find a way to jump out. I had a third reason that the lids were great, but I forgot what that was. Evaporation, heat, fish jumping out. Yeah, I think those are enough. The Mode Aquarium retail rack comes with a basic sump, usually with several baffles, but I removed most of those baffles and left a center one to act a little bit as an air bubble baffle, also to act as a brace for the entire thing. And I drilled a float valve here, which goes to a 50 gallon pickle barrel, so I have an automatic top off without any plugs. And under here, you can see it's actually quite simple. Despite the Dursos, with the water flow that I was getting in here, it was so freaking loud. It was gurgling very loudly and irregularly, and it was the most disruptive thing ever. And so I decided to put the Clarisse Gen 2 automatic filter roll, and that thing has completely muffled the sound. You can see how close we are to it. And there's almost nothing to hear. And obviously it has the added benefit of automatically filtering all mechanical waste out of the aquarium. One of the other challenges was finding a very good high efficiency protein skimmer to fit in here. So I went with the Tunzi 9410 DC skimmer. This is one of my favorite skimmers ever. I've been using one on my 60 gallon at home for about 4 or 5 years, and I wouldn't trade it for the world. It's been only going for a few days, but it's already skimming a bunch after just a couple of days. And as I've mentioned, I'm using the Vectra L1 for the return pump, and it's actually plumbed into an 1.5-inch riser pipe for a really, really great flow rate and pressure. And you can't really see it in there very well, so I went and pulled out the box for the John Len Micom heater. It's a really high quality heater made in Taiwan, and I'm going to show you that thermostat here in a little bit. But then the last thing to know about this system is I pre-cycled a giant Brightwell BioBrick here. So that's all the surface area for biological filtration that this tank probably needs. I've got a few more small bricks inside just to kind of act as a decoration, and also that's what I've been putting my nori on when I feed these guys. So the last thing that I did to tie together this entire aquarium and make it really nice and neat cohesive package is I managed all my wires. So I got everything basically plugged in and wired up to the back. So the power outlet is up there, the power strip, and I've got all my little different controllers here, but I'm gonna start off with the heater. So this is the John Len Micom heater here. It only reads in Celsius, but one thing that's really cool about it is that you can calibrate it. So the temperature that you get, you're not stuck with it if it's a little bit inaccurate. There's a small screw on the back. I haven't calibrated this one, but I trust that it's 25 degrees, which is 77 degrees Fahrenheit. And here you can see all the different controllers. We've got the Vectra Quiet Drive for the L1 here, running just under 50%. We've got the controller for the Tunzi 9410, also running at 50%. These are the light switches for each of the strips. I really like being able to control both the white and the blue separately. And then last but not least, a tiny little controller here for the Clarisse Gen 2, where I can kind of either reset it or advance the filter roll as needed. And I'm so fanatical about this that I even spray painted the power supply for the Vectra L1 so that from a distance it looks really clean. This cable wiggling here in the middle, that is just the studio light. And the last thing that I'm going to need to change is the power strip that I have that's powering this entire aquarium. It's got a black cable, so you know we're going to have to change that out just to make sure it's all white. So although I will eventually, you know, get my hands on some exciting, rare, funky, unusual fish, I really have a soft spot for some of the most common aquarium fish that you can see in the aquarium behind me. So we've got firefish up on the top row. We've got 12 of them. I've got 6 yellow tangs and 6 convict tangs. Those guys are gonna be an important part of my algae eating army. I like to use 3 different types of tangs. So 1 zebrasoma, that's a yellow tang. 1 acanthurus, that's a convict tang, and 1 tinochetus, the bristlemouths. And for those, my favorite is the tominy tang. So there was no tominies available last week, so I had to stick with those. And then finally, I've got some Kupang damsels here in that tank right there. Just a beautiful blue and yellow fish, just to kind of help fill out. I don't know what those guys are gonna be for yet, but I'm sure I'm gonna find them a pretty good home. So I'm really, really thrilled to have the fish system completed because, like I said, unlike a reef tank, it doesn't have that many moving parts, but I'm really, really thrilled with the parts that I ended up selecting for this tank. The system comes with some really, really nice lights, so I didn't have to adjust that at all. But the Vectra L1 return pump, powerful, quiet, only running at 50%. The Tunzi 9410 DC skimmer, super, super short, stubby, really quiet, really efficient. And that Clarisse Gen 2 is going to export so much nutrients before they ever have a chance to break down and cause nitrates to build up in this aquarium. So what's next for this tank? The fish have been there for about a week. Really enjoying having some movement here and being able to see a tank, you know, from the side as opposed to the coral tank over here, which is only top down. Really adds a nice touch of life to the Reef Builder Studio here. And I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just give them a really small dose of copper just to kill off any potential ick. Now, we don't have any sand in here, and that's where ick likes to breed and proliferate, but I'm still gonna dose a little bit of copper just to make sure to knock them back before the fish go into any other tanks, because so far there's no trace of ick in the entire studio. But you know that's not gonna last. But otherwise, yeah, I'm just gonna enjoy these fish, ride them out, and you know, just enjoy feeding them and enjoy the basic common aquarium fish. And I'm sure it won't be too long before you get another update to, you know, see what kind of neat, interesting fish I've come up with to add to the Reef Builder's fish quarantine and conditioning system. So I hope you enjoyed this little overview of this particular fish system. Like I said, it's really, really rewarding to have one thing completed and to have it come together so well, so efficiently, and so quiet, so quiet. So I want to give a huge shout out to Mode Aquariums for sending me this fish rack and for Eric to come out and help me set this up. I think I'm doing you guys proud. And yeah, this thing was a perfect fit for the studio. Looking forward to getting a lot of use out of it. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you really, really enjoyed this video, give me a subscribe and comment down below if you have any questions about fish handling, fish quarantining, or any other details of how I'd set up this aquarium. So I hope you like this video, and I'll catch you guys next time.